geriatrician, one of the most common reasons that people come to see me is to talk about changes in memory that have been noticed. It's quite common that we make the diagnosis of dementia or major neurocognitive disorder in the office. In fact, we make that diagnosis usually several times a week. And the most common cause of major neurocognitive disorder is Alzheimer's. People who are diagnosed with dementia, with Alzheimer's, have probably been experiencing symptoms for quite some time, maybe even years. And when we deliver the diagnosis of dementia, it is a turning point. Many people have wondered about what was going on and noticing that something was wrong, and perhaps had an inkling that it might be Alzheimer's or something else. But receiving that diagnosis and getting confirmation of that is a threshold. It's a difficult one to cross. The thing about the timing of the diagnosis of dementia is that the early stages of Alzheimer's, for example, are actually preclinical. So somebody could be living with Alzheimer's 4 years before the diagnosis is made. And the person has probably had a good quality of life during those years. The person has probably made strong connections and enjoyed strong connections with other people, pursued meaningful work or other activities, and had some fun along the way. Some of that can continue even after that diagnosis threshold has been crossed. Sometimes it's important to think about that when we're making that diagnosis. I don't know what it feels like to be diagnosed with Alzheimer's, but I did have an experience where one of my kids was diagnosed with a learning disability. And I remember when the clinician used that word learning disability, I burst into tears. My perception of somebody who had a learning disability was that they had limits. Their life was not going to be normal, and that this was a big problem that we had to deal with. It turns out that my kid has been able to do just about everything they want to do. And in fact, years later, having been retested, they actually don't meet criteria for a learning disability anymore. I guess neuroplasticity was a positive in this case in a young person who was able to work on some areas of brain performance and improve. That's usually not the case with Alzheimer's. But I remember that feeling that life had changed and parts of life were over because of that diagnosis. A diagnosis is a label. It does have meaning. It does mean that there might be different ways that we have to treat the person, different therapeutic options, different lifestyle changes. But it doesn't mean that the life is over, and it doesn't mean that the person is a different person than they were before they walked into the office. Receiving a diagnosis of major neurocognitive disorder due to Alzheimer's or some other disease is very challenging, and support is available. Whether you're finding this diagnosis difficult or you're taking it in stride, I would recommend getting in touch with Alzheimer's Society. They have excellent resources, and all of their work involves helping people who are living with major neurocognitive disorder and their families to live as well as they possibly can. Have you ever received a difficult diagnosis, Alzheimer's or something else? Tell us about it. And thanks for watching. Hey, it's Dr. Dybbuk checking in to see if you want more wrinkle. That didn't sound right. How about if you want more of the wrinkle? If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you didn't like it, give it a thumbs down. There's a space below to leave comments. And you can always hit the little red rectangle to subscribe. There's lots more wrinkle over on Facebook as well at The Wrinkle 2. Thanks so much for joining us here today. And I'll see you again soon on The Wrinkle.